Now, in today's session, we are going to discuss about the description of a design pattern. Our today's concept is description of a design patterns. First of all, what is a design pattern here? A design pattern is a general repeatable solution to a commonly occurring problem in a software design. So, now in this subject we have discussed completely about designing of a software, which means architecture and structure of a software. So these design patterns are used to help a to give us some solutions. What they will give? They'll give some solutions. So those are which kind of solution they are going to provide us? Those are the repeatable solutions, or we may call it as reusable solutions. So for which purpose? Whatever the problems we are getting while designing a software, if you want to design a software, or if you want to make some solution for a given problem. Actually, why are we developing some software? To overcome some problems of a real life. To make everything is comfortable to a human being, isn't it? So what are the problems are facing by a human being in real life? To sort out that, or to reduce such kind of problems, we are going to develop some softwares. So actually we are developing software from one kind of problems, real-time problems. So here the pattern or the software is a problem or problem statement. Now we are providing the solution to that problems while developing a software product. We are producing, or we are developing some solution to the real-time problems which are faced by a human beings. So that's why here also, while designing one software product, there are so there are some difficult situations are there while developing that one. So how to handle that situations? How to correct that problems? How many solutions are there with us? Which solution is best one to implement this code within a given budget and within a given time? Like that, there are many many kind of what constraints while developing one software. We have many kind of problems and some rules and regulations and something. By maintaining those constraints while developing this project, then we should develop one project, isn't it? So here we are going to provide a solution to the patterns. So here the pattern may call it's a overall software, or it's one module of that particular software. What is a pattern here? Pattern in the sense, just it's a one kind of problem. That problem may be a overall problem of our project, or it is a one part, one module of our project. It's called a pattern. Now we are going to take the different solutions for the patterns while designing those patterns. Clear? So this is about the definition of a design pattern. What it is? It is a general repeatable solution to a commonly occurring problems in software design. Or those are the reusable solutions of the problems. Okay, right. See the second point. The solutions are evolved from the features of in design patterns. We are providing some solution to the patterns. Okay, those solutions came from the OOPS principles or OOPS programming language, object oriented programming language. So whatever the design we are going to provide to the patterns in the form of classes and objects, what we are going to do here? Okay, we are going to do whatever the solutions we are going to, okay, made for a pattern. Okay, those are in the form of collection of classes and objects. Okay, OOPS principle. Class and object are the, part of a OOPS principle, isn't it? So now we are going to develop a pattern. We are going to develop a design for a given pattern. So that is in the form of, okay, collection of classes and objects and the relationship between those. Okay, so this is about a one of the important patterns in, one of the important point in design patterns. So now we are going to description of designing patterns. Till now we have seen some definition about design pattern. Now what is our main concept, today's concept? It's a description of a design pattern. So the description of design pattern, in the sense, it provides solutions how to solve a problem that can be used in many different situations. If you have a problem, so what are the solutions, how to solve that problem? Okay, what are the approaches we will follow to solve such kind of problems? That is called the description of a design pattern. Clear? The description of a design pattern means, okay, it's a solution to solve a one problem. So how we are going to choose that solution, how are we following, okay, that approaches to solve one problem. Okay, that is called a description of a design pattern here. Okay, by using some format here in design pattern, we are going to use one format, consistent format, to describe the design patterns. Clear? There is a format is there. By following that format, we are providing a solutions to the problem. All right? Okay. Each pattern is divided into sections. So here each pattern is divided into sections according to the following template. Okay, what is a template? So the template has, already we have discussed this template points and elements of a design pattern in previous class. We have discussed some elements of the design patterns, four patterns. So those will be presented in this template itself. Okay. Once again, we'll see each and every point. So this is about a template of a design pattern. What is the first one? Pattern name and classification. So every template must have a name. isn't it? So not only every pattern, everything, every problem, every solution must have a name in real time. Okay, so here also our problem or whichever, okay, some pattern have one name here. Okay, pattern name and classification. Okay, the pattern name, whatever we are going to, okay, choose, that conveys the essence of a pattern. So the what it includes, the pattern name, it will give the information about a pattern. So that's why we need to choose some good name, and also it will become a part of design vocabulary. So while choosing a pattern name, we should take on some vocabularies. Why? Because if problem is one, so for naming that problem, we are going to give some favorite actor names. We are going to develop some software problems, isn't it? We are going to develop some real time problems of a human being. We are going to develop some software project. So for such kind of project, if we give some actor's name or some animal's name or our pet names, is it good names? No, these are not the those are not suited to our work. So while choosing the pattern name, that should be related to our problem as well as our solution, our design. While looking one name itself, we can get some clarity what it includes. What is that product, what it includes, what is the solution. Like that, we may get clarity while watching, while seeing the particular name itself. That is the power of name. So choosing of name is also an important role in everywhere. Choosing of one name to a particular product. It's also impression, or otherwise one kind of solution to a problem, or one kind of motivation. So anything, if you will see one name, it will be like that. In our real life, we are having some liquid product that is called Vanish. We have one product, so Vanish. What is the purpose of that product? If we will use that product, on some spots or some dusty things on our clothes, then it will be completely going. So what is the meaning of word of a vanish? It's completely erased or fade away. What are the dust which have with our clothes? So cleaning of that dust from that clothes by using some vanish product. That is one kind of product to clean that kind of dust or some kind of marks on clothes. So by seeing the name of a vanish, automatically we got some feel. We will buy this one, so all the marks will erase easily on our clothes. Like that, we got some feeling, isn't it? So like that. So every product in real time, whatever the products we are developing, those products names should be suited to that product. Then only it will give some good impression on that product. So we are going for some online railway reservation system. Why are we calling it as railway reservation system? Why? Because we are going to access the rails information. We are going to work with going to book a ticket on railways. That's why we are having online railway reservation system, like that online library management system. So online library management system means, okay, there is a library, we are going to perform transactions, we are going to take a book or issue a book by online from that library. So that's why that name is called online library management system. So like that, each and every product has some name. Those names replicated the work, the function of that particular project, isn't it? So like that, here the pattern name is also important. It replicates the problem and the solution of that particular product. Clear? So that is about choosing of a pattern name. Coming to the second point, that is intent. Second point is intent. What does the design pattern do? Actually, what is the intention of the design pattern? What it going to make or what it's going to do? Okay. Is it rational and intended? Intended? Or otherwise, what is a particular design issue or problem does it address? Which kind of problems, issues it is going to be addressed in real time? Okay, is this design is going to use which kind of these problems are you going to use which kind of designs? Okay, what is the intention of those designs, and whether those designs are addressing the real time problem or not? Okay, this is about the intention. See the third point, also known as other well-known names for the pattern. Okay, if any, we are going to choose the well-known names for the pattern itself. Okay, by choosing a pattern name, so we should take care about that pattern name. And why are we designing, why are we going for solution of that particular pattern? Okay, is it pattern completely address the problem or not? Okay, by using which techniques it is going to address such kind of problems? So if we will keep it everything in our mind, then we are going to design a pattern, we are going to fix one name for that particular pattern. Okay, next see the motivations. What is this? Motivation. A scenario that illustrates a design problem and how the class and object structures in a pattern solve the problem. So now we are going to, we are having some words. One is class and one is the object. So by using class and object structure, how we are going to, solve a given problem. And see the second point, the scenario will help understand the more abstract descriptions of the pattern that follows. It will help to understand the more abstract descriptions of the pattern. So in that problem there may be many hidden things are there. If you want to provide a solution to one problem, that problem may be deeper one or bigger one. So all of our solutions are enough to solve such kind of problem or not? Whatever the scenarios we are going to develop, those are help to understand hiding things of that particular problem or not. This is about motivation. And if you'll go and see the next slide, applicability. What is the next one? Applicability. In this applicability, So we are going to know what are the situations in which the design patterns can be applied. Okay, what are the situations in which the design patterns can be applied? In which situations we are going to apply these designed patterns? Whether those are accept that design patterns or not. Okay, for some problem, but to solve some problem, we are making some designs, okay, or we are making some solution to that problems. Whether those problems are suited, whether those solutions are those designs are suited to that particular problem or not. If we will apply those designs into that problem, okay, is it apt 100% or not? It will give, okay, exact results to that particular function or not. So like that we are going to assess in this applicability. In applicability, what we are going to do? We are going to assess whether this design is suitable to that problem or not. It will be fit into that problem. Okay, to solve that problem. Okay, whether it has any kind of poor, for example, see here, second point, if it is have poor designs, how the pattern can address? Okay, which means the design is not that much okay, suitable one to that problem. So what we should do? Okay, how can recognize a situation? Okay, this is about the applicability. Applicability in the sense here we are discussing about the solutions which are provided for a given problem are fitted or suited into that problem or not. If those are suited, it's okay, everything is happy. Or not, so what we should do? Which kind of steps would we take at that time? So what we will do? We are going to do some repair things which we have learned in software architecture. If we will buy one component, okay, if that is not 100% matched to our problem, it's not fitted into our problem, so what we should we do there? First of all, we are going to repair and we are going to additional features to that component, then we are going to use that one into our project, isn't it? So like that, here if we'll make one design for a pattern, a problem, if it is suited 100%, so we are happy. Otherwise, here we are going to change that design by applying some small modifications. That is called repair section. We are doing some repair on that particular solutions again. Okay, this is the applicability. And coming to the structure. So, structure in the sense, graphical representation of the class in the classes. What it is? Graphical representation of classes in the patterns using a notation based on the object modeling technique, OMT. Here we are going to develop a design structure by using OMT, object modeling technique. This object modeling technique, okay, use the maybe class diagrams. Use the class diagrams to provide a solution to a problem. This is about structure. So the participants. Next one is participants. The classes and our objects participating in the design patterns and their responsibilities. Okay. What are the participants of this design? Classes and objects. Already we have seen this DP. Okay. Almost design patterns are almost worked for object-oriented programming languages only. That may be either C++ or that may be either Java. If you want to provide a design for these classes and this kind of programming language, always we are going to provide a solution in a class diagram. So what a class diagram has classes and objects and some methods, isn't it? Those are the participants of that class diagram. Class diagram is a structure for a one kind of pattern. It is a design for a given problem. Okay, we are going to provide a designs by using classes and objects for a given problem. Clear? After that, here we are also having some collaborations. Okay, these are all the templates, subheadings. Now, whatever we are discussing, those are applicability and pattern name and motivations. All are the subheadings of a pattern, isn't it? Template. Sorry, these are all subheadings of a template. Okay, so now collaborations. Collaborations in the sense how participants collaborate to carry out their responsibilities. So how many participants are there in our design? Classes and objects, isn't it? Those are the participants. Now those participants are how to work, how to collaborate their works, how to carry out their responsibilities by collaborating each and with one another. So that is called a collaborations. Coming to the next one, consequences. So what are the consequences we will get if we'll design a pattern? First one, how does the pattern support its objectives? Why are we going for this development of this software? Whether it will reach that objective or not. This design, getting ready, the design is support or suitable to our objective of development of this particular software. See the second point. What are the trade-offs and results using the patterns? So, what are the compromising situations? What are the balancing situations? Into that designing of a patterns. So where should we compromise? Where should we balance? Is there any need of compromising in some functions or not? In some situations or not? While providing a solution to one problem, so we may not give 100% 100% suitable and clarity solutions for each and every small problem or big problem. There is a little kind of compromising situations may raise or may occur into that problems. So if we'll compromise for something, that will give any kind of problems, or there we won't get any side effects if we'll compromise on some solutions. So what are the results? If we compromise there, what are the results? What are the side effects for developing one software or for developing or designing one pattern? So that is about a consequences. We are going to compromise, okay, on some work, on some design. Okay, is there any need compromise of in some situations or not? If yes, what is the result? If no, what are the results? Okay, is there any side effects, sir? Okay, occur while implementing or while using of that particular software product or not? If yes, how to overcome that particular side effects also? So like that, we should take care about, okay, each and every main point, okay, small point of this design. Next is the third point. What aspects of the system structure, okay, does it let vary independently? Okay, if some independent functions, independent solutions are available, so how to deal with those? How to deal with those? So these are the consequences which we will get while developing a project. So next, so implementation. So while implementing this particular design is taking to the next step. What is the next step after designing phase? It's the implementation phase. Okay, if you want to go to implement such designs, so what pitfalls, hints, techniques, okay, what pitfalls, hints, techniques should be aware of when implementing the pattern? Aware of when implementing the pattern. Okay, what are the precautions we should take while implementing those designs? Which kind of techniques we should apply onto the design? How many member of, I mean, how many number of people are needed to work on that particular design? So like that, we are going to take care about each and everything. So while designing itself, okay, we should have complete knowledge about that project. Then, okay, by based on the complete knowledge of the design, so if what are the complicated things or complex things will occur in implementation, how to overcome those, how to solve those within a smooth manner. Okay, where I mean taking the precautions while implementing those projects. Clear? And are there language specific issues? Okay, which language we are going to use? So those la that language, which means which programming language we are going to use. Okay, that language is suitable to this particular problem, or to find out a solution to that problem or not. Okay, if in that language also, is there any kind of drawbacks are there to implement these solutions or not? Like that, we should take care about the all the steps. We need to mention, okay, each and every point, okay, in a template of a DP. We are going to mention the template. Okay, after that, if we are going to describe, the next one is, if you are going to describe sample code in sense code fragments that illustrate how might implement the pattern in C++ or Yeah, all of you, we can leave the class. It's almost done. Okay. You can leave the meeting.